It's me, Ma'am Lady! And for today's video, we will be learning about future tense and its form. But before that, let's roll the intro! And for today's video, we will be learning about future tense and its forms. And future tense, according to its definition, expresses an action in the future. Or sa Tagalog, kilos na mangyayari sa hinaharap. Maaaring bukas, maaaring sa susunod na taon, sa susunod na buwan, o sa susunod na araw. And like the past and perfect tenses, or present tenses, it has four forms, such as simple future, future progressive, perfect future, or future perfect, and perfect progressive future. First, let's talk about simple future tense. Simple future tense, according to its definition, expresses an action that will happen in the future. It is formed by combining the word will plus the basic form of the verb. Meaning, will plus the basic form of the verb is the formula for the simple future tense. Pag sinabi nating basic form, ito yung original word. Or, yun yung pinaka-word niya. So, for example, kapag nagsabi tayo ng action word or verb na build, ay build yun. Hindi mo siya papalitan into built. Hindi mo rin siya papalitan ng has built. Okay? But, it says, will build. And that is your simple future tense formula. And another formula for the simple future tense is am going to plus is going to plus are going to, whichever is applicable. So for example, am going to can only be used with the word I or with the pronoun I. So I am going to talk to you tomorrow. Okay? Or if we will be using the is going to, automatic, that is singular. Your subject is singular. So for example, Ma'am Lady is going to talk to you tomorrow. And if you are going to use the are going to, automatic, your noun or your subject is plural. So, Ma'am Lady and her kids are going to the zoo tomorrow. Okay, so that is your simple future tense. Or, also, the simple future is to predict a future event. So, for example, since it's in the future, again, it's a prediction of what will happen in the future. So, you are going to say, it will rain tomorrow. Do not forget the word will because that is an indication that that is simple future tense. And do not forget your time indicator such as tomorrow, next week, next year. Next form is what we call the future progressive tense. Future progressive tense also expresses an action that will happen in the future. It is also a continuing action, meaning to say, continuing is tuloy-tuloy sa Tagalog, okay? That will happen in the future. And your formula for that is will be plus the verb ing or the present participle of the verb. So for example, Jason will be hosting the party tonight. Notice that there is the formula will be plus your verb ing, hosting the party tonight. And when it will happen? Tonight. That is your time indicator. Again, your future progressive tense is a continuing action that will happen in the future. Alright, so another example could be, I will be staying here until Sunday. Meaning, magmula ngayong Monday hanggang Sunday, dito lang ako, magsistay lang ako dito. So, it's a continuing action. Tuloy-tuloy na action that will happen in the future. Another one, the postman will be coming soon. Okay? Will be coming soon. Meaning, anytime of the day, of the night, anytime. Okay? The postman will come soon. So, the postman will be coming soon. And do not forget to click the picture here because it will lead you to a link with a lot of explanation also. And the next form that we will be using or we will be learning is the future perfect tense. Now, the future perfect tense expresses an action that will have been completed or finished by a certain time in the participle of the verb. Remember, we have discussed about perfect tense. And when we talk about perfect tense, it means it has been completed. So, the future perfect tense is an action that will have been completed. Dapat ay matatapos na o mangyayari na siya sa certain time or sa given time ng action. So, for example, Dorothy will have accepted the job offer by Wednesday next week. Notice that the formula will have plus the word accepted, even if it's in the past tense, okay? Naka-past tense si accepted dito. Still, it's considered as future perfect tense because of your will have. Plus, your time indicator that says a certain time either by Wednesday or next week. So, Dorothy will have accepted the job offer by Wednesday next week. Another one, the future tense is also used to indicate a future event that has a definite end date, meaning to say merong kang deadline. Kapag ginamit mo si future perfect tense, ay meron kang deadline. So for example, Shannon will have gardened by then, meaning to say dapat si Shannon natapos na niya ang pag-garden niya ng araw na yon. Okay? And that is your future perfect tense. Next type or next form is what we call the future perfect progressive tense. Again, future perfect progressive or perfect progressive is a combination of an action that has been completed, that is your perfect, and progressive is an action or a continuing action. Tuloy-tuloy na nangyayari. So, it has been combined and we call that your perfect progressive tense. So, future perfect progressive tense expresses a continuing action in the future that will have been going on for quite some time already. It's just the same with the future perfect tense. The only difference is your formula. Your formula is combination of will have been plus ing form of the verb. So, your verb ing. So, for example, by next month, Jojo will have been practicing karate for 10 years already. Kung iintindihin natin sa Tagalog ang sentence na ito, by next month, sa susunod na buwan, si Jojo ay nakapag-practice na ng karate 10 taon na. 10 taon na siyang nakakapag-practice ng karate sa susunod na buwan. So, by next month, Jojo will have been practicing karate for 10 years already. Notice that the action is continuing. Why? Because it has been 10 years already. And notice that your indicator is the word already, meaning to say it's a continuous action. And at the same time, it's an action that have been going on for quite some time. So, ibig sabihin, tuloy-tuloy na action siya magmula noon hanggang ngayon. That is your future perfect progressive. Another example could be, by the end of November, Jack will have been studying at the university for 4 years. So, notice your time indicator, the end of November. The end of November is your time indicator. Jack will have been studying, meaning dapat nagsastudy na siya or nagsastudy na siya sa by the end of November sa university for 4 years. Meaning to say, 4 na taon na si Jack na nag-aaral sa university. So, by the end of November, Jack will have been studying at the university for 4 years. And that is your future perfect progressive. Again, if you click this picture, it will lead you to link of explanation. So, another example for your future perfect progressive tense, By that time, Shannon will have been working here for 2 years. Your time indicator says by that time. Sa araw o sa oras na yon, siya ay nagtratrabaho na for 2 years. So, once na yung oras na yun dumating, ibig sabihin, 2 taon na siyang nagtatrabaho. Again, future perfect progressive is a continuing action in the future that will have been going on. Sabihin, tuloy-tuloy siyang nangyayari for quite some time already. Okay? So, by that time, she will have been working here for 2 years. Another example could be she will have been living in Ireland for 10 years at that point. So, dapat siya ay nasa Ireland for 10 years at that point, nung panahon na yon. If it's midnight, he will have been sleeping for hours by then. Kung tatagalugin natin, kung madaling araw na ngayon, siya ay natutulog na ng mahabang oras, or marami na siyang oras na natutulog. Again, future perfect progressive expresses an ongoing action or a continuing action in the future that will have been going on for quite some time. And do not forget your formula will have been plus your verb ing. Now let's try by answering this future tense exercise. Number one, Liza will be playing the role of a princess in our program next week. What do you think is the future tense? Or what do you think is the form of the sentence? Yes, that is your future progressive. Notice the formula will plus be plus your verb ing. And it says that it will happen next week. Time indicator is next week. Next, Liza will have played the role of a princess at the end of our program next week. Meaning, si Liza daw, or sa Tagalog, si Liza daw ay dapat mag-portray ng isang princess at the end of our program next week. What do you think is the answer? Yes, that is future perfect. Notice your formula. Will plus have plus the past tense of the verb or your past participle. Next, number three. After next week, Liza will have been playing the role of a princess for 3 years already. Sa Tagalog, pag natapos na itong week na ito, ay 3 taon nang si Liza na nagpe-play as princess. What do you think? Correct. That is your future perfect progressive. Notice your formula will have been plus verb ing. And your time indicator after next week. Last, Liza will play the role of a princess. What do you think is the answer? Yes, this is very easy. The answer is simple future or future simple. Why? Because of your formula will plus the verb original form or the original form of the verb. Now that you know your future tense and its forms, all you have to do is to read articles, read books, and identify the tenses of the verbs. Stay tuned for more learning videos. Do not forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell for more updates. See you again!